In this video, I'm going to connect to the database, and to do that, I'm going to be using Mongoose, which is a great way to structure your collections and also to interact with MongoDB. So let me Google it. I'm going to search for Mongoose, and here it is. So if I go to this quick start guide, first of all, I need to install it, of course. I'm going to say here npm install --save Mongoose. Okay, so now I need to require it. So I'm just going to paste it here. And I'm going to have a comment here actually. And I'm going to say connect to DB. So let's see, to connect I need this. So I'm going to paste it. And this test is going to be CMS cart in my case, since that's the name of the database. And I also need this. So copy that and paste it here, and on open I'm gonna console log connected to MongoDB like so. Okay, so if I start the server now, let's see what happens. And I seem to be connected, so it seems to be working, but I'm gonna just separate this a bit. I'm gonna have this connection, this string actually, I'm gonna have in another file. So I'm going to create a new folder and call it config. And in there, I'm going to create a database.js file. Okay, so here it is. And in here, I'm going to say module.exports, which is Node's way of exporting stuff and using it in other files. And I'm going to have an object here, and I'm going to say here database. And I'm going to copy and paste this connection string. Like so. And in here I'm gonna say var config, and I'm gonna require config slash database. And then in here, instead of this literal string, I'm gonna say config.database. So this database is this right here. So let's see, and it restarted automatically because of the changes, and I still seem to be connected. Just to double check, let me stop the server and rerun it, and it's all good. Okay, that's it for this video. See you in the next one.